Okay, how's it going? Here again with another game. This is RuneScape. For those of you who've never seen RuneScape before, this is the so I'm doing this one because the client's just been updated to NXT and the graphics are a bit of an improvement. Yeah, so I'm going to have a look around and show you the world as it looks through NXT. As you can see, I don't know if you've seen any old footage of RuneScape, but the draw distance is about maybe 3 or 4 times what it was, sort of thing. It doesn't really help in here because that just looks like it goes into infinity, and so does that. It's a bit strange, but yeah, the water looks pretty schmicko, like you're getting some effects and stuff like that. Yeah, it's sort of, you'll see there are some issues as we go around. So I think the best way is to show off this place is to basically do what I usually do, my daily routine, and do some farming, and that takes me everywhere basically. So I'll do what I usually do, and so I've got a quick preset. The only thing that doesn't pop up sometimes is the crystal seed. That's fine, because it's easier to go and find a crystal seed than it is to and there's a nice gap for it and stuff like that. And if I've got a 2 charged crystal teleport seed, it'll load it up. So that's the sort of way I manage degradable items. When I load a preset, I sort of I just have like a crystal teleport seed at one level. It saves me getting a new one every time, because that's sort of annoying. Excuse me, but yeah, it's sort of easier. So so I basically, what I do when I log in, I start off with a bit of glitching there. I start off with a farming run, a herb run, and I'm growing fly traps and sunchokes just for a bit of extra experience to boost my overall experience and stuff. If you've never seen RuneScape before, this is actually a port, player-owned port. I guess I'll do a video on this later. I've done a video on it, but that was ages ago, and I've done a heap since then. I don't think it was updated, so I might do it in HD, whatever this is, NXT, because it looks better, sort of. So I won't explain it too much, but it's basically like a massive mini game, and you just keep going. And there's a quick glimpse of my resources. So I'm working on making 200,000 of each resource. I'm getting there. I had to spend a bit of jade when I rebuilt some hotspots. I made cherry trees. I had what did I have there? Like telescopes there? Gyroscopes? No, those things that get adventurer voyages, because I needed to get the goo set, which I did get eventually. Where are you? This is my costume tab. Goo. There you are. Master goo, waggy, and the way of the goo, and yeah, goes well with my Tetsu's katana and wakizashi. Yeah, I haven't augmented them. I've augmented my dry gores, working on leveling them up. But anyway, so yeah, I'm here to show off NXT, so I will teleport to Trollheim and start there. So this is Trollheim. So you can see the draw distance makes it a lot more interesting. You can see a lot further and stuff. See the whole troll land. Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's got a weird, I don't know, it's just as colourful. It just hasn't got, it's not a vibrant sort of thing. I guess you're up in the mountains and sort of fogging and all that sort of stuff, like atmospheric effects. But there we go, there's the colour. That's better. Yeah, that's a bit better. That's how you think it would be, more colour, sort of like that. See, that happens a bit. So I guess that port, player and port, was super colourful anyway, so they had to tone it down. And then when you come here, it has to reboot and become more colourful because there's not as many colours. I don't know. But yeah. Ooh, a bit windy outside. The curtains blowing around and stuff. Yeah, so trolls and stuff, so they don't look too much different. They've still got all the same textures and stuff, like everything's still got the same textures really. they're just more clearly defined, I guess, and it's pretty smooth. I'm running at 30 frames a second. I could probably run at 60. Like, this game, I'll just say now, like, it works the computer a lot harder than classic RuneScape. Like, my computer, it's well, my computer can handle it. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's working pretty hard. It's working almost as hard. It's working harder than it does than when I run Fallout 4. So that's strange, considering what you're actually getting. I don't know why it has to work so hard. It just doesn't. I don't know. So I basically play in the low quality. Not the low quality. The old Java client, because it just uses less resources, and because you're playing for a long time, you're not gonna you don't want to use heaps of power. Like, this is using a lot of power. Like, my computer, my fans are running, it's generating heat, that's all power, and this is the sort of game that you play for a long time. So that if you're playing a high performance game, you're only gonna play for a couple of hours and then you're gonna give it a rest. This is supposed to be played for hours and hours on end, and you're gonna burn through the power. So that's why I'm not gonna be using it in my regular day-to-day sort of work. Anyway, it looks good. Like, I'll do quests in it maybe, and demonstration things. I don't know if you can hear the dog barking. I don't know, she's just being stupid. So I will get my Aurora going, my Juju on, and it's fine. So I'm just going Lantern on at the moment. So I know this is pretty boring doing farming around, but I'm just basically able to see that. See, that's pretty cool. You can see all that sort of area. Not the Lady of the Lake, although it's something similar. It's like a ghost or something like that. It's a quest or something. It's like a barbarian Lady of the Lake type thing. Or is it a troll? I'm not sure. Yeah, it's definitely, I think it's a in. Anyway. I don't know if you hear the music going. I don't have my. I don't know if that changes it for you, but I didn't have my headphones in, which was. Oh, there's a nice grey square on the ground. Teleport. That's sort of distracting me for the moment. I don't have much time to really. Ooh, my shadow just rose. So here we are in Mauritania. Right up the end, they can Port Phasmitis. It gets pretty grey over that way, but here it's quite colourful and vibrant. You got shadows and stuff happening. And then you've got your undead cows are slightly glowing, which is strange. They're definitely glowing, but that's okay, I guess. There's snow lilies, but it's a bit strange that they're glowing. See, things just look a bit weird. Like, it's just nice, it's smooth, it's just not polished, I think. I don't know. Maybe I just have to get used to it. Like, I guess they have a lot of work to do. Like, I'm not exactly sure what they're going for, but if they're going for super high quality, I guess they are. So they're gonna have a lot of work to do with their textures and stuff like that. Like, the repetitive textures, they really stand out now. Like her thing just looks stupid, you know. Her top, the textures on it anyway. Like, what sort of texture is it supposed to be? Like, is it supposed to be wool? Like, it's just a massive, coarse sort of thing. I mean, that's a repetitive texture, but it's a field, so you'd expect a sort of repetitive texture. Anyway, getting around, picking this stuff. So yeah, this is Cabbage Patch Kid, just south of Falador. Some proper cows, and they look, I mean, cows can't labor, I mean, they look a bit ridiculous. They look like very childish sort of thing, and they look unrealistic. And it's weird because they go for a lot of realism in some things, and then some things are just like cartoony and weird. It just gives it a strange feel. They should really redesign cows. The old cows weren't too bad themselves. They were just sort of, you know, round things. Didn't have much detail, but they looked fine. Mm-hmm. This is definitely some music you would have heard if you played RuneScape at all, like, because this is one of the first songs that sort of came out, because it's a free area. Very nostalgic. Moving on, no time to be nostalgic. Might keep going to the next area anyway. Whoa, that's floating in blue then. Always a gourmet and things. They're never bloody anything decent. Because they sort of look like magpie inklings out of the corner of your eye. I say the seed, yes. Yeah. And then you scroll over and they're always a bloody gourmet and thing. Bit of flashing there. So, yeah. The old Juju and the Aura go pretty well together. Give you a couple extra. I've got the modified Pharmasap and Botanist masks. Yeah, they're pretty hard to get. They're quite useful, but not many people. Well, a fair few people that have them, but not everyone has them. That's for sure. Like, you had to play the Treasure Hunter pretty hard to get them. Get them all anyway. Yeah. So and actually they provide pretty good advantage, which is I don't know, it's probably not fair, but I shouldn't have fertilized that, waste of fertilizer. Anyways, still got one left, and the leprechaun's got a few. So anyway, sorry, I should have been looking around. Yeah, Barrick, that was Catherine back there. It's pretty good. Ranting about how things are bad. Yeah, so, I don't know if that's glow. There's weird things. Things glow. Things that probably shouldn't glow. The bloom, I think, is broken. Or something. Yeah. But yeah, no, it looks pretty cool. The extra distance sort of gives you a bit more perspective on the place. And we'll quickly, I'm running well short of getting to this one in time. Okay. No matter. We've got 60, so 60 is about average, is what you want to get from the run. So hopefully I'll get one or two boosted. At least to get one extra. So this is Prifiddinas, very Welsh sort of language. I'll have to do a running of here, so yeah, it looks pretty confusing and stuff. I'm just circling around like this crystallurgic waterfall. I just I completed that. Sort of, I got all like 5,000 large urchins and bought a boot for a hermit crab, which I caught after like 4,500. So that took a while. I've been leveling up my a crystal rod for an augmented crystal rod for invention. So yeah, that's the thing. It's going to take a lot of work. I'm only 51 at the moment, and my target is 99 for now, and then I guess I have to push on to 120 because there's content all the way through now. Yeah, so the first target I guess is 33, and then maybe by then I've got a better way, like, to make millions and millions and millions of experience without spending millions of GP. I know you've got to spend some, but for what it gives you, I don't know, it's pretty excessive. I guess you could think of it like construction. I like construction. Construction's my favourite. So that was my herb run. I guess I should have showed off Cathaby a little bit better. Might have gone for a run along the beach. Maybe I'll do that. I'll just what I will do is I will load up my next preset for the bushes. I don't need the crystal seed at the moment, but I will take Ring of Jewelry. I only need one. I will use this thing, because I've been gradually using that. You can only use one a day, that's what it's left. Okay, I'll go through, I guess I'll go through at some stage my bank and all that sort of stuff. But yeah, I'm just sort of showing off my NXT at the moment. And yeah, maybe I'll go for a run around. Maybe I'll do that now. I'll just draw this plant, harvest this. Should we get an extra for that? Yay! 238, that's a decent chunk of inspiration. That's good. His elf zombies are pretty weird, actually. Yeah, okay, so let's go for a quick run. Have a look. There's the waterfall. There's my elder tree. So this is the Chris, I say Chris. C-R-W-Y-S, I mean what? So you got your harmony pillars over here. I don't really bother about these, because I will show you, actually. I've got 19 minutes left for my perfect brush, I might take another dose of it. I will show you how I get harmony moss. But yeah, I just plant whatever. So if I ever make whatever, how many EXP to get them to grow, I will harvest them happily. But yeah, it doesn't really bother me, because this way is much better. I'll drink that. So yeah, perfect plus potion. I've got so much of it. It lasts 240 minutes. It's however many hours, 4 hours, whatever. 4 hours, and it's every perfect potion, the effect. So why wouldn't you just have it on constantly? And look how many doses I've got, and I've got like this many crystal tree blossoms. So that's what makes them with harmony moss. So why wouldn't I? Continuing our tour of Prifiddinas, I will say. We have, we're going into the health area. This is the agility sort of area, and there's like a church up here. Well, guess what? A little church. Fruit tree here. This is Melee here, I think. I want open fruit. There's like a shop in there, I think. There's a very, very, lonely gnome glider there. I don't know if anyone's ever used him. I don't know what the point of him is, because it doesn't bring anywhere near a bank. And so up here we've got a church. Oh, I can get up to it. There's one around that way. It's like a dark stone that you've got to cleanse or something, and it gives you corrupted cherry stone, that's it. You've got to cleanse it. And probably never gets cleansed, so it just lasts forever. It's a way of training for air. I think it's a very low intensity sort of thing, and just AFK way of training for air. You've got the pillars, the health and pillars. That's the way to train agility. You just have to follow the poses. You've got the course. I'll do a quick lap of the course. It's pretty spectacular. The old health and agility run. Go. Whoop, it's white. Just crush the top there. Okay, it was strange. This one, there we go. Whee! Should be a bit more exciting music for this, I think, but then you go around the side here. And the velocity, when it builds up, you can skip one of those obstacles, it goes over automatically. It's handy though to turn it, it might have been a shortcut. And there are shortcuts, there are a couple of shortcuts. But you can turn it off if you're about to finish or something, or you want to save it for the longer clicks. You can turn it off and sort of suspend it, and then you come back and that's one done. And then you get a random item. I don't think I've got anything spell. Yeah, so that's pretty fun. It's a pretty fun way to try and and you can get some cool stuff from it. Yeah, the only problem with bigger draw distances is you can see there's like nothing there. There should be at least trees there, I would have thought. I don't know why it's green, but... So we're going to Amulod. This is like the summoning guys. Shadow Claws in there. Kill them. They're pretty, they put up a decent fight. They've got a lot of... life points, and then you chuck the claws in there and cleanse them and stuff. There's an obelisk here you can make pouches with. I haven't done that this month. It's first of May. Okay, yeah, cool. Alright, they've reset. There's one of the pillars that you, statues that you make for heaps of construction experience. Here is, I was going to come to here later because I've got to do this at some stage. You make your crystal decanters out of this stuff. It's a bit extra. Now that's the only place you can get it, that's right down. And the other one's a red sandstone which you make flasks out of, which is something else. What's that? Down in here, this is what is this here? Kadan, is it? Ethel, that's right. So that's there's a house in there. I'm gonna go to the house later, I'll show you the house. Maybe in this one, I don't know how long this is gonna go. It's probably want to keep less than an hour anyway. Here's Iowerth, these are the guys of the fighters. There's a crystal chest in there, that's handy. It's running around here. That guy is a good slayer master, he's tough, and there's a challenge in there, you gotta fight waves of monsters. It's a requirement for a completionist cape and stuff. And moving into Trahan. You got some mining. Everyone loves their mining there. It's a pretty good experience. Don't get anything from it, just experience. A little tree patch over there. Dead willow. No. My willow died. There's a couple of runite ores and maybe even a couple of adamantite. There's definitely some mithril, coal, all that sort of stuff in there. Go for it. There's a furnace in there. What's back here? Anything back here? No, that's right. It's just a church. I think Kadan, that's over there. Kadan. There is it. So these guys, I don't really have much to do much in here. But there's some pretty handy stuff. I used to be able to get in there. There's the old, I can still get in this bit. I used to be able to get into the tower. I can only just get in here now. This is a little garden of flags. There's the invention banner. I'll unfurl that one day. There's all the other skills banners and stuff. Yes, this is I used to go in there fairly. This that's my empty slot there. You can see was for my max cape. So I used to keep it there handy. Why am I carrying around my tumbleweed? Anyway, I've got a set to Crystal Tree. There's some portals, very handy portals there. Crystal Tree, it's rather than having to find it, just jump in the portal. And that one's high level Runespan, so I plan on doing Runespan at some stage. I can be bothered, there's a lot of things to do. What have we got? It's flax and a loom. Yeah, so not much, but there's a, what's that guy? Don't go anyway, just for show. I don't remember them being there. This is going back into, yeah, okay. There's a thing over here, you can switch your periwink and your curses, and your spellbook, prayerbook and spellbook. Sorry, boss, did Did you like that? I clicked my fingers. I usually do that to call her, so she heard it. You're right, puss. Man. You're all right. I'll give you a pat. There you go. Oh, give me one a pat. Yeah, anyway, moving on. So that's about it. And coming into the central bit here, I guess. I've drone around the outside. You can see that's where I came from. The bushes. This isn't. I thought that was Chris. Anyway, doesn't matter. So the crystal tree. That's where you get your crystal fruit from. Yeah, they're good. They're hard to get though. You got to catch a crystal lintel, and that's about the only way I think you can get a crystal seed. Not sure, there might be another way. I think you could give them one maybe as a reward from a quest, maybe something like that. But they're pretty hard to get, so if you get one, yeah, it's worth getting, obviously. Anyway, moving on. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Oh, I should have showed you Serum, but it doesn't matter. Maybe I'll show you Serum in a sec. So here we are, Remington. This is a very beginner area as well. This is the first sort of house portal that you go into, you use. Very colourful thing you have to see there. This agility, this is Barbary, gives you agility experience as well as farming when you check it. Yeah. It's a little sleepy little town. Oh, there's a magpie thing. Yes. What do you got for me? Ooh, two shields. I will. This is another one because they usually give stuff that I need. Possibly, possibly not. It's hard to tell. I need a lot of different things. Yeah. Let me just quickly go back to Prifiddinas. Oh, that's a bit. Thingy. Okay, go upstairs, have a little serum. I think I've, she starts out pretty broken, and then you go through a few quests and you restore her. And, well, I guess spoilers. and yeah, there she is. There's a god of the elves. Doesn't let me talk to her for some reason. Am I lagging? No? There she is. On the World Guardian, yay! So there she is. Saren. See if I can get her close up. I shouldn't have talked to her. Don't mind me. There she is. Hey, Saren. So yeah, the four eyes, like Zarasaur has four eyes as well, at least, as far as we know, and she might have more as well. That definitely designed with the four things as sort of Zaras has as well. Oh yeah, she's made of crystal, obviously, so and all that. She just disappeared, little crystal floating around her head. Anyway, yeah, there you go. Backstory, the old king. Got himself a nice bow there. Anyway, yep, so that's great. Let me just zap back to Catherby, show you a quick look. Let's see if this works. Yeah, that smoke is a very frame rate droppy. Just itself, like the rest of the game looks fine, it's just that. Now let's have a little run along the beach. Ah, yes, balloons. I think that's, that might be in Trainer, actually. Isn't it? Jeez, it's not far away. Doesn't look far away, does it? No, that's got to be Karamja. No, there was a balloon on Karamja, but no. Give us a light up. Got the pineapple plant there. See, I can't get to any of that. That's over that side. There's a balloon there. So yeah, that is pretty much irrelevant to this area. Like, you wouldn't usually be able to see that in the old one, so yeah, that's a bit confusing. Makes you think, like the gaps you jump in this game, you'd think you'd be able to jump that gap. will come in anyway. Okay, the fishing bubbles. That looks pretty cool with the shadow on the ground. That's pretty cool. The water, I don't know, it's a little bit glassy. And looks a little bit, when I'm on the right, it looks a little bit, looks like lava or something like that. Looks like it has a really viscous consistency, like when you look at it like that. Anyway. Okay, great. Moving on. Let's go and plant another barber bush. So the loading times, I guess, are not too bad. And you can see sort of the shadow moves as where you're on the, what position you are on the map sort of thing, I guess. I think they need to release a map with the equator on it and the topographic, not topographic, the navigational stuff. Because it would really help get a grip on where things are. Like treasure trails, I guess, is where the most thing where you do that, where you track that those coordinates down. But yeah, just to get a handle on what the planet sort of thing and the size of the planet and stuff like that. Like it'd help you get a lot more of a grip on how these lands sort of are affected by weather and stuff like that. I don't know, it's just a thing. You don't really need it, I guess. Okay, so yeah, this is south of Arnay, or Adong. I've heard it, people with Jagex say Adong, but I prefer Arnay. It sounds better. It may not be the right pronunciation, but Adong sounds just stupid. I prefer Arnay. All these lands look a bit silly too. Like, they're all over the place. There's some, they'll go away once the 15-year anniversary is up. But anyway, okay, moving on. Just jump up on the in front of my face. See, moving on, that's good. To mobilizing armies. So this is basically at the south end of the map. So this is basically like Australia. You can see there are gum trees over here, eucalyptus trees, and there's red sandstone and stuff. So this place, and there's platypus you can catch further up on the world map. I'll bring it up actually. Stop moving. Not that I have to stop moving, but it helps. And very dramatic music. Come on, load up. Shouldn't take that long to load. Good. I'm right at the south end here. So this is the beginning area. This area was released way after I started, so I've never really had much. There's a quest I did there and a few other things there, but not much. That's a mini game area. That's like where the staging area, and that's where you fight. That random area. There's a reason for that. Like, I think it's a quest, part of the quest you're on that thing. That's definitely a quest, like a trans area to get to Ape Atoll. That place is really fun. You've got the tropics, so this is the tropics through here. This is the Karazi jungle. That's the pretty wild jungle. Like, you've got need quests and stuff to get in there, and it's used to be pretty dangerous. It's not anymore. And this is just the normal jungle sort of through here. There's a few bits and pieces through there, obviously. Another place, the desert. Desert's quite large, actually. Got a few little towns around the place. There's Nada, Polivanich, Uza. You've got, this is like another tropical sort of area. It's pirates. Lots of pirates. It's a pirate place. Mostly animals. Harmony is, they're monks, they're zombie monks, so that's pretty cool. There used to be a tough quest there. I don't know if it's tough anymore. There's not too much quest stuff that's tough, really. Old stuff, anyway. The new quests they come out with are pretty tough because they deal with EOC mechanics, EOC evolution of combat, using all abilities and stuff like that. We've got this one. So this is all for vampires and stuff, werewolves, zombies, and I guess you'd call them zombies or whatever they are. Ghosts, stuff. Lots of stuff. This is basically the free area, just in this area here, basically. Trollheim, that was where they went up there, the Blade Wilderness, player versus player area. Anyway, if you know RuneScape, you know this. Let's move on to Accelerate. There's a cat, what are you doing, man? What do you want? Just walking around in front of my face. See, some things glow really, really brightly and strangely. This. And I will break this. Just talking to the cat. That will keep my favor up. I need to collect that, but I don't know. I may have collected today. I usually collect it, give it 7 days, so I'll do that at some stage. So this is Accelerea. This is the other side of the island. Or is this miscellaneous? This is Accelerea, yep. Now miscellaneous is the main one. I'm the king of this place. And they give me stuff. But I've got to keep my approval rating up, so. And so the last barbie bush. Sorry, this is taking a bit long, actually. I've just been yapping on. But yeah, you can see it's not a major improvement. Like, I guess the biggest thing is the draw distance. It gives a different feel to the game. You can definitely see further. The shadows, I guess, give it a bit more realism. It's pretty cool. As I said, it's probably not worth the extra resources used to play it. See, a lot of people playing this game on laptops basically fried their computers because just how hard the computers have had to work and... nice. Another 342, that's a good burst. And basically all these people with sort of half dusty computers and stuff and not the best graphics cards are finding their computers are getting fried because their computers have to work so darn hard to run this stuff. I mean, I don't know why it has to run things so hard, you know. It's quite strange. Off to Alcarid. So this is south of Arik. It's pretty much the same as all the other places. Wish I had some water. I don't. Guess I could pause. Flip it. No, I'll just keep going. So this is Alcarid. There's a town. It's safe to run around here, like there's no thirst issues that you get running around here. To the south you do, definitely. It's pretty cool. It's a fair bit happening here it's a beginner area. There's a lot happening around here for a beginner to do. There's a furnace pretty close to a bank. There's a town that's also not too far away. There you go. There's the furnace in the town there, and there's the bank. So that used to be like the place to basically go, especially if you're a free player. I guess if you couldn't use Edgeworld, the Edgeworld furnace, that's a lot closer. I bet you got to do something to get that or something, if you might remember. So I will go to Cesar City. Cesar City. The music is getting pretty wild there. Yeah, so this looks pretty cool. This place looks pretty cool. The bloom works on these because they're lava and you'd think they would be blooming, like lighting up a lot. So yeah, this place is pretty cool. The floor's pretty shiny, I don't know. It's alright, I guess. It's like a crystalline sort of structure. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Go, just run over to the center here. The full effect. Get some lava, see some lava happening. Nice. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. I will just tell you back there. And so this is a bank. This is the place I like to bank. Ooh, we've got some 60 frames a second action happening there. Although I'm locked at 30, so I don't know why I'm reading 60. Yeah, it's a good place to bank. And yeah, here's where the balloon's a bit out of control. I mean, look at that. That's crazy. Everything's just glowing. They need to reel in that balloon a little bit. Like, those mushrooms. I don't know if they're supposed to glow that much. Everything's like got watery eyes or something. You're trying to blink out the light. They're very very bloomy. And so we'll head off to the dangerous bit. Well, not really dangerous. The place where you lose health if you hang around too much, if you don't have water. Just to collect the cactus quickly. And let's have a look around here. So that's looking up into Lumbridge. That's the swampy area underneath Lumbridge. Beginner area. And you're just looking down into the desert. So that looks pretty cool. With the increased or just draw distance, that's pretty effective. I like that. That's sort of one of the places where it really works. Because, yeah, you're looking off into it. There's the Dominion Tower in the desert, in the distance. That's where you fight all the bosses. Yeah, so that really works. Because, yeah, I just think it works. It's cool. That was weird. I was holding my... Because you need a Dremon staff to actually use these fairy rings until a certain point, until you do a quest. So that's probably the position that you use. You put your arm up with the Dremon staff. So that's why the shadow was already in there. That was interesting. Let's see if we can catch it again. There you go. So I missed it. And okay, so we're back into Mauritania again. So I'm under perfect plus potion effect, and I will show you what happens. You get Harmony Moss. Not every time, not all the time, but you definitely at least get two or three out of each go, and sometimes more. I've done all the tasks here, so I don't have to worry about these dying, so I can just go and heal, plant them, note them, which is really handy, and have a look around here. So that's the old town of Canifus. Got the old people walking around, they've got a secret. I'm pretty sure you can guess the secret, and you're looking down south into the swamps, which is, again, it looks pretty cool. There's probably a bit more detail, maybe, would help on the outside, but of course, they can't do too much detail, because that's the whole point. There's a fairy ring in there, too. So that looks pretty cool. There's the old Holy River, so no vampires can cross that river. Yeah, that's cool. Moving on, like the red glow from the lamps in the cannabis there. No, I didn't need to come back here anyway, sorry. I wanted to go here. So we're off to the elf lands to have a look-see. So we're almost at the end of our journey. We've covered a lot of ground. just by teleporting around, doing farming and stuff. I'm trying not to yak too much, but obviously I have. So here we are in the off-grounds, looking south over the poison waste. There's a nice stand of yews in there. You can see a nice stand of magic trees over there. Yeah, that's pretty cool, and there's a little, later, I think you'd call it. Letia. Yeah, it's a cool little town. Yeah, this place is a bit of a maze. It's got full of traps and stuff. It's the Earthlands. This is the place that the elves were confined to before Prifiddinas was built. Like, that was only built, I know it's been built a while now, but maybe over a year, but this game's been around for like, 15 years. So yeah, for the longest time there was nothing there, and this was like the only old place. You're not always going to get Harmony Moss, but you got a very high, much higher chance of getting it. And it builds up. Yeah, so this wasn't here. This is a pretty new, this patch. Like, that patch wasn't always there. That's a camp there for the humans. They're trying to make inroads into the elf lands. They never really did. They never got that far. Okay, and now we're off to get some Lizvax. Lizvax comes in really handy in all sorts of situations. I'll stand up and have a look around first. So we're looking out towards Lumbridge, south of Lumbridge. Yeah, along the coast is the old mine. Many an hour I used to spend in the free world years and years ago, fighting for the one or two mithril and the four coal or something that's in there. Looking, that's Draino down there. It's, yeah, that's pretty cool. So it gives you a bit more of a view. That's the Port Sarum, all the ships in Port Sarum. Looking out there. Bit of a desert, sort of. It's heading down the Mud Skipper Point. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, you get a nice view from up here. Now, you couldn't really see anything like before. And you've got your bloom going crazy on your portals there. And we're in here. So I'm going to grab myself some Bizvax. And that's about it. So I'll just go through my Bizvax stratagem. It's not really much of a stratagem. But, basically you want to go through and check all the runes that are usable. The combination runes, they're just so ridiculous. Like, they're expensive, and to make them is just a nightmare. And in the quantities you need, it's just really not worth your time and effort. I will lock them in for now, just to make sure I've got the 100%, and then I'll go back through and I'll check. I'll try and get as close to 100 as I can. This is what I do, sort of work it out. I don't mind how many guesses I'm using, because I have enough of the runes that I'm going to use to do it anyway. So just working through. There we go. Unfortunately, it's another combination room. It's just there we go. Okay. So now I've got to work through and find 97. That's not too bad. See if there's 98. I might just stick with that. 98's fine. And if I can get to 97 or something, that would be cool. There we go, 97, done. Deal. I can miss out on 3, that's fine. Because I've got a ton of all kinds of challenges. I've been working through that today. I was going to do this before, but then the cat jumped on my lap, so I thought I'd just get into that a little bit. Vizvax, anyway. You can extend auras. I will actually extend my aura this one, it's only, it costs different for different auras to extend them, but because I want to level up a crystal rod, augmented crystal rod, that helps a lot. An extra hour just gives me much more time. How many pillars so I can reset? How many pillars? Not that I want to. Divination, so you can give yourself more, like there's things you can collect from, you can give yourself more, they're unlimited, you can give yourself, increase your limit. Quick tellies, I put a few into them, I never use quick tellies. So that means you can use a thing to instantly go there rather than use the home teleport, but you, it's not worth it. Really not worth it, because by the time you do it, by the time you select it, just teleport and you get there, it almost uses as much time as the home teleport anyway, really it does. So, doesn't matter. So that's about it. I will talk about other stuff later, but that's a good selection, that's a good run around the NXT world to show you what the different places are and how it works. Yeah. Hopefully that was instructive. Hopefully you got something out of that. So I guess I'll do a few more videos on RuneScape about what I've got my bank and ways I do things and stuff like that. And I guess I have more to say then. So until then, catch you later.